Good morning, girls. I'm Dr. Kiran Deshwal. Today, I will teach you the story Three Questions, composed by Russian writer Leo Tolstoy. Leo Tolstoy wrote this story in 1903. This is one of the stories which Tolstoy contributed in aid of the Jews left destitute after the massacres and outrages in Kyiv and elsewhere in Russia. These outrages possibly prompted the yet more terrible Jewish massacres of 1905 that shook Tolstoy to the very core. Through a crisp narrative, the story reveals the importance of the present in life. It is now that matters in our dealings, for the past is irretrievably gone and the future is still hidden. The most important time is the present. The most important person is the one we are dealing with at that moment. And the most important thing is to do good to our fellow beings. This moral is conveyed through the story of a king who wants a kind of formula for success in life. The most appropriate time to do a thing, the right person to deal with, and the most important action. Various answers come to his way, but he is not satisfied. He goes to a hermit as a seeker to learn the answers. The hermit does not say anything directly, but elaborates on the incidents of the day to provide convincing answers to the questions. So, for the introduction of the author, refer to my PDF notes which I have shared in yesterday's PPT on WhatsApp group. And let us begin our story. Before beginning the story, let me tell you that in this story we have a king who is curious to know what time is important, who are the people who are important, and what is the thing which we should give priority and which we should do first. So to seek his answer, he goes to a forest where he received the answers from a hermit. Let us start our story. It once occurred to a certain king. This idea came to the mind of a king that if he always knew that right time to begin everything, it was the desire of the king. He wants to know the right time to begin everything. He was curious. He was curious to know that at which time I should start a thing. If he knew who were the right people to listen to, he wanted to know to whom I should listen to and whom to avoid, to whom I should avoid. And above all and before all these, if he always knew what was the most important thing to do, which thing I should do first, which is more important. He would never fail in anything he might undertake. This will help him in decision making or doing any action. And this thought having occurred to him, as soon as this idea came to his mind, he had it proclaimed throughout his kingdom. He announced in his kingdom that he would give a great reward to anyone who would teach him what was the right time for every action. He wanted to know what is the right time to begin any action, and he announced that anyone who give me the right answer, I will award him. So, and who were the most necessary people and how he might know what was the most important thing to do. So here we have three questions. The title of our story is Three Questions. What are the three questions? The three questions are, what is the right time for every action? Who are the most necessary people to listen to? And what is the most important thing to do? And learned men, intellectuals came to the king. Intelligent people came to the king. Scholars came to the king. But they all answered his questions differently. There were different answers of each question. So the king was unsatisfied. In reply to the first question, The first question is, what is the right time for every action? The answer of this question came like this. The right time for every action, one must draw up in advance a table of days. To know the right time, we should draw a table of days, months and years, and must live strictly according to it. We should follow that table. The answer was like this. Could everything be done at its proper time? They suggested the king that if you want to do everything on right time, first of all you should draw a table of days and months, and then you can do every action and thing on proper time. Others declared that it was impossible to decide beforehand the right time for every action. It is impossible to tell what is the right time for every action, some said so. But that not letting oneself be absorbed in idle pastimes, one should always attend to all that was going on and then do what was most needful. See, some suggested that one should not let oneself be absorbed in idle pastime. We should not waste our time. We should always attend to all that was going on and then do what was most needful. We should do the needful things first, necessary things first. Others again said that however attentive the king might be to what was going on, it was impossible for one man to decide correctly the right time for every action. Some suggested that no matter how attentive you are, you can't decide the right time for every action, but that he should have a council of wise men, council, a formally constituted advisory body, the people who advise you on matters, the group of people who advise you on matters. It was impossible for a man to decide correctly the right time for every action, but that he should have a council of wise men who would help him to fix the proper time for everything. So we have seen that there were various answers for the first question. But then again others said there were some things which could not wait to be laid before a council. Sometimes we need an emergency action, we need instant action over such things, so we can't put the matter before the council. We have to take the decision, but about which one had at once to decide whether to undertake them or not. But in order to decide that, one must know beforehand what was going to happen. It is only magicians who know that, and therefore in order to know the right time for every action, one must consult magicians. So it was a funny suggestion that some suggested the king that you should take advice from magicians because they know what is going to happen. Equally various were the answers to the second question. Some said the people, the king, to whom to listen most. Second question was, who are the persons to whom I should give importance? So some said that the people the king most needed were his counselors, others ministers, the priests, others the doctors. King need the doctor most, king need the priest most, king need the ministers most, while some said that the warriors were the most necessary. So to the third question, as to what was the most important occupation, which thing we should do first, some replied that the most important thing in the world was science is most important. Others said it was a skill in warfare is very important, and others again that it was religious worship is very important. All the answers being different, the king agreed with none of them. As all the answers were different, so these answers couldn't satisfy the king and gave the reward to none. So the king rewarded to none, but still he wanted to find the right answer. But still wishing to find the right answers to his questions, he decided to consult a hermit widely renowned for his wisdom. Thanks for watching. We will be continuing.